My name is Richard Wardle. I'm the manager of weather services for the Queensland office of the Bureau of Meteorology. Brisbane's Mount Stapylton radar will undergo a midlife upgrade to further extend its life by about 10 years or so. To do this, Mount Stapylton will go offline for approximately 4 weeks from late August to late September. Currently, the radar sends out a horizontal pulse which identifies precipitation but is not able to distinguish between rain, hail, or even snow. The upgrade will provide our forecasters with a more detailed picture by sending out both horizontal and vertical pulses, which will enable them to distinguish the size of the object detected. The upgrade has been planned at a time of year when severe weather is less likely and ahead of our northern wet season. During the upgrade, forecasters will continue to draw on observations from a range of sources like nearby radars, satellites, lightning detectors, automatic weather stations, flood networks. While the Mount Stapylton radar is offline, for southeast Queensland, you can use the nearby radars of Marburg and Gympie as an alternative. And for northern New South Wales, they'll have the radar from Grafton to provide that information. Another tool available to the public is MedEye, which provides information on a map of current weather. MedEye also provides significant weather forecasts for thunderstorms, rain, fog, and frost. There's also satellite and lightning imagery available from Himawari 8 satellite. This technology scans Australia every 10 minutes and users can zoom into an area for a closer look. So we're asking the public to be patient while the Mount Stapylton radar is offline and to check the radar pages for any updates. The good news is that when the radar returns, its life will have been extended by a further 10 years and the forecasters will have the ability to distinguish between rain, hail, ice pellets, bushfire debris, and even the occasional snowfall.